Sermon for December 13th, 2020. Father of Hermeling in Dorsten, December 11th, 2020. The so-called Chancellor of Germany, Angela Merkel, speaks of hope. There is hope that there will be a vaccine against Corona. The Catholic Catechism teaches the theological virtues are faith, hope and charity. Hope is a divine virtue infused into our souls by which we confidently expect from God whatever he has promised us through the merits of Jesus Christ. Angela Merkel is member of the Rotary Club. In 2013, Rotary Club of Glenview, Illinois posted on Facebook, Pope Francis, the newly inaugurated Pope of the Roman Catholic Church, is a Rotary brother, as well as a Jesuit and an American, albeit a South American. Francis, as Cardinal Bergoglio, is an honorary member of the Rotary Club of Buenos Aires, Argentina. So much for the bad old days when a Roman Catholic could not be a Rotarian. Rotary was considered satanic and an aspect of Freemasonry. It is not true that there is a Pope Francis and that the condemnation of Rotary by the Church has been changed. However, it is true that Jorge Bergoglio is a Rotarian and that one of the Rotary founders was a Freemason and that Rotary is satanic. Jorge Bergoglio is the visible head of the biggest satanic organization, that is, the group of the so-called Second Vatican Council. In its statutes, Vatican II spreads the heresy that non-Catholic societies can be a means of salvation. Accordingly, in 2017, Jorge published a 92 seconds long YouTube clip, the Pope video Interreligious Dialogue, with the message, in this crowd, in this range of religions, there is only one certainty we have for all. We are all children of God. No revelation, no faith, no obedience, no salvation. Remember the words of Pope Leo XIII about the kingdom of Satan, in whose possession and control are all whosoever follow the fatal example of their leader and of our first parents, those who refuse to obey the divine and eternal law. At this period, however, the partisans of evil seems to be combining together and to be struggling with united vehemence, led on or assisted by that strongly organized and widespread association called the Freemasons. We wish it to be your rule, first of all, to tear away the mask from Freemasonry and to let it be seen as it really is. While it is explicitly forbidden for every Catholic cleric to be a member of Rotary, many so-called clerics of Vatican II are Rotarians. Freemasonry and Rotary have many aspects in common, for example, the vaccination propaganda. Vaccines are obviously considered as an enormously powerful tool for destroying well-being, life, virtue and grace. Recently, a study was published. Relative incidence of office visits and cumulative rates of billed diagnosis along the axis of vaccination. We performed a retrospective analysis spanning 10 years of pediatric practice focused on patients with variable vaccination born into a practice presenting a unique opportunity to study the effects of variable vaccination on outcomes. We could detect no widespread negative health effects in the unvaccinated other than the rare but significant vaccine-targeted diagnosis. We can conclude that the unvaccinated children in this practice are not overall less healthy than the vaccinated, and that indeed the vaccinated children appear to be significantly less healthy than the unvaccinated. That is exactly what over 250 years of vaccination have shown. There is no evidence that vaccinations do any good, but there is a giant amount of evidence that vaccinations do harm. And harm is the whole spirit of vaccinations, because a vaccine is a cocktail of harmful substances allegedly to activate the immune system. So do not care about healthy nutrition, healthy exercise and in general a healthy lifestyle. On the contrary, just get an injection of poisons and pathogens and whatever. Just get your flu shot, your corona shot, your measles shot, your whatever shot, and you are a good person. However, if you prefer to live healthy, you are an evildoer. Therefore, Rotary pushes vaccinations like crazy. In 2019, Rotary reported an announcement at the Rotary International Convention in Lisbon, Portugal, set the stage for a bold new chapter in the partnership between Rotary and the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation in the campaign for polio eradication. Going forward, the Gates Foundation will match 2-to-1 up to $35 million per year. Every dollar Rotary commits to reduce the funding shortfall for polio eradication through 2018. If fully realized, the value of this new partnership with Rotary is more than $500 million. Already in 2018, with Centers for Disease Control and Prevention reported, a vaccine-derived poliovirus is a strain of the weakened poliovirus that was initially included in oral polio vaccine and that has changed over time and behaves more like the wild or natural occurring virus. This means it can be spread more easily to people who are unvaccinated against polio. These viruses may cause illness, including paralysis. And in 2017, the World Health Organization reported, on rare occasions, if a population is seriously under-immunized, an excreted vaccine virus can continue to circulate for an extended period of time. The longer it is allowed to survive, the more genetic changes it undergoes. In very rare instances, the vaccine virus can genetically change into a form that can paralyze. Now back to the super spreaders of Satanism, that is the group of Vatican II. Jorge Bergoglio keeps preaching that an eventual vaccine for COVID-19 would belong to the world. The vaccine is the patrimony of humanity, of all humanity. It is universal because the health of our peoples, as the pandemic has taught us, is a common heritage. It belongs to the common good. As a reaction to such a remark by Bergoglio, the director of the World Health Organization, Tedros Adhanom, tweeted, "I couldn't agree more with Your Holiness. The COVID-19 pandemic shows that we must make health a human right for all and not allow it to be a privilege for the few. It also gives us an opportunity to rebuild a better, safer, fairer world together." Remember that the first visible head of the group of Vatican II, Angelo Roncalli, nicknamed Pope John XXIII, began his work with the praise of the United Nations, and the bond of the Satanic Vatican and the United Nations have been strong ever since. Considering all that, we Christians cannot share the declared hope of Angela Merkel in a vaccine. However, we Christians do have the hope by which we confidently expect from God whatever He has promised us through the merits of Jesus Christ. Apparently, the servants of the kingdom of Satan, the partisans of evil, are now combining together and are struggling with united vehemence against God. Apparently, there will be severe consequences for anyone who does not want to serve and worship the devil. It might be life-destroying to reject a vaccine. But ask, how life-destroying can a vaccine be? So do not give up your hope, even when evil seems to be mighty, and even if devil worshippers declare that they are full of hope. This time will end. Satan and all his followers will suffer eternal damnation, and whoever has been faithful to God in his Catholic Church will receive eternal salvation with all the saints in heaven, in the kingdom of God. Amen.